to Game Studio Tycoon 3. I've seen Jacksepticeye play this. At least I think it was. Or was it Markiplier? Well, was one of the guys. And I decided, hey, why don't I get it? I was going to play Assassin's Creed for you. Identity. But apparently I didn't have enough space or some shit like that, so I was like, fuck you. And let's see here. And it's Tropic Filter. What is this? Anti-aliasing. What the hell? What the hell? Sound like a freaking what's the name? I can't think of the name right now. So, what achievements will we begin? Published. Release a game. Win game. So, okay, this is cool. Okay, so okay, I can't think of that. Okay, so let's just get started. Spent so much time. Ooh. Easy, since I don't know what the hell is going on. Studio name. I'm gonna be me. Oh, please. Okay. Language, English. Uh-oh. How do you go back? I don't want to go back, Mac. Just want to... Uh-oh. I screwed up. I screwed up. And customize. Oh, student name. Blazes. Oh, forgot they passed me. Oh, fuck it. I didn't know how to spell Samina. Will you stop that? Well, fuck you too. Places audio and video recordings. No, never mind. Take that back. Dump. Crib. No, not a baby crib. J-E-F-F. Happy place. Okay. Just stick with it, right, guys? Freaking kidding me. A-L-A-Z-E across stream. Don't want that. Stick. I guess we're just okay. Here we go. About an hour. That is fine. Okay. We wait. Welcome to the game studio Tycoon 3. Your goals are simple. Release great games, make money, and stay in business for 50 years. 50 years? Are you fucking insane? You can create games, hardware, and accept project contracts in this menu. Nearly everything in this panel is about making money. Creating a game is easy. First, select the platform that the game will be released on. Pick your genre and theme. You can select up to two genres and two themes for each game. Select the game engine and make your game on. If you want to get a good review score, you should pick an engine with a tech level equal to or greater than a tech level on platform you selected. Next, pick a team to work on your project. Each team can only work on one project at a time, but they can also have two additional projects. For when they are done. Just make sure you have employees assigned and teams select. Which, being a new person, you know, I'm new.
I don't have employees working for me.
So that's some bullshit that we're talking about right here. So, the next task when creating the game is to set the distribution of the game points. For an example, if your primary genre is music, you should probably focus on most of your employees' time creating sound points. Finally, you can set a target tech level for a game. Reviewers expect a game to meet simple settings. The target isn't enough. So, your employees will need to create enough tech points to meet the targeted level. Games that with high tech levels targets should be assigned to team with a lot of employees. If you research the ability to create games, your publisher will create that menu by clicking this button. Publishers select platform buyers and things for the game for you. They also give you money up front to help with development costs, and your game will accept more copies. However, if you fail to meet the technological or score requirements, you will be penalized. You can this is the conversation manager menu. You can determine how much money you want to spend in a studio at a various game conservation at the start of the game. There aren't many conservations, but they grow in popularity over a few years. Why do you have so much? Review your past projects and hardware. In this menu, you can see how your stats were distributed for a game, as well as the game themes, genres, platforms, and what the average review score was. Also, you can see a chart of the weekly sales. This is the data menu. You can view your annual review and expense for each year, as well as how much money your investors are making. You can also view what your average game rating is over the past few years, as well as how much your studio is worth compared to your competitors. And finally, this is the research menu. You can unlock the abilities to create new types of projects and hardware. Are you done? You're not done. Fuck you. This is the panel. You can take out and pay off loans in here. You can also find investors who will pay you money for stake in your company. This menu will show you how many fans you have for each genre. You can also view the age and preferred platform of your fans. This is very important to your data, as well as it will affect how much money your game will make. This will open the pause window, which allows you to save your game and return to the menu. How stupid are you? Oh, fuck you. The book shows you all the necessary data about a project that a specific team is working on. You can click the project name to open a window, which will have more information about the project. As you see, there are four differently covered boxes. The blue box signifies tech points, green is for logic points, and red is for graphic points. The yellow represents time points. That's the basics. Good luck and have fun. Yeah, the basics. The basics. Oh my god. I only have 15 more minutes to front because you fucking had 15 minutes of typing. What the fuck? Wait. Whoa, okay. Let's do stealth for the first one. Let's do. I want to do something else. Story driven. Select animation. How much do I have in the bank? Let's take it down some. Trying to get to 13. She's going to drive me insane, man. Let's see. Okay, turn it. Okay. secret project. I see, said the blind man.
Thank you.
I wish we could. I would have known this earlier. Thank you. Definitely don't know what the fuck's going on right now. Thank you. I'll get better at this. Promise, guys. What the hell? It looks so cool. It looks so cool. Only got 1 out of 5. Guys, thanks for watching Game Studio Tycoon 3. And I will see you in the next video. That's maybe